Next, I'd like to show you how to prepare roasted chicken with your iCombi Pro. When I come over to the iCombi Pro, you can see here on the control panel, we have the cooking mode for poultry. I'm simply going to select that. Once I select that cooking mode, then all of the cooking paths come up for poultry. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to scroll down here, and you can see that I have the roasted chicken button. I'm simply going to select roasted chicken. The next step is the iCombi Pro allows me to set my settings. It's wanting to know if I want to do it with or without the probe. What sort of coloration am I looking for from light to dark, and what sort of internal temperature do I want? For this particular application, we're going to go with the default settings. I can also see down here that I'm getting the message that the iCombi Pro is preheating. Next, I'd like to talk about how to properly spike the chickens if you're using our super chicken spikes. Super important when you're spiking the chicken and when you're seasoning the chicken, if you're looking for even cooking results, we definitely want to make sure that we have even seasoning throughout the entire batch. In order to spike the chicken, I'm simply going to lift the chicken up, and I like to hold the chicken up with one hand here. Then what I'll do with my free hand is I'll come over and I'll actually cross the legs of the chicken onto the spike, making sure the most important part for me is just to make sure that we get that keel bar right behind the chicken. I then like to take the wings and fold them back, and there you have a perfectly trussed chicken with no string required. Just to show that one more time, again, I like to hold the chicken up with one hand, come over to the spike, cross the legs, make sure that the keel bar gets inside of the chicken there to hold the breast up, and then I'll simply fold the wings back. And now we have perfectly trussed chicken all ready for the iCombi Pro once it's finished preheating. So I can now see that the iCombi Pro is telling me that it's ready to load the roast chicken. I'm simply going to pop open the door. Take my chicken spike. We'll place that right into the unit. I'm going to use a little drip pan to catch the fat. And then I want to use my core temperature probe, and I'm just going to go ahead and eyeball and find the largest chicken on the spike. And I want to go ahead and take that probe and place it right into the thickest part of the breast of that largest chicken. You'll see now that the iCombi Pro is going to bring up the cockpit. And I can go through the cockpit to show you exactly what's going to happen and so that you're comfortable with the cooking path that's going to take place. I can see now that the chicken is roasting at 392 degrees in combination mode with 90% humidity, adding very high moisture at the beginning of the cooking path. The next step, you'll see that we're going to go to dry cooking mode, and we're only going to allow 50% of the moisture to remain inside of the cooking cabinet. This is super important to have that high moisture at the beginning so we can make sure that the interior of the chicken is very, very moist, but we also want to make sure that we have that perfectly golden brown and crispy skin on the outside. And here you can see the iCombi Pro is going to do that for us all automatically. It doesn't know how many chickens we're cooking right now. It doesn't know what size of the chicken is happens to be on the probe. But the iCombi Pro is going to use its intelligence to figure all of that out and make any necessary adjustments to the cooking path for you automatically so you won't have to worry about it and have to come back and tend to the chicken until it's done. Well, I can see now by the blinking lights and the zeros on the panel that the roasted chicken is done. I'm just going to go ahead and pull out our core temperature probe, and then I'm going to place that probe right back in its holster. Now I can remove the chicken, and you can see how beautiful, even, brown and crisp that chicken is. We'll carve into those in just a moment. Before we get to that, I'd like to talk about the end options. I can see here now that I have the option to move the probe from a smaller product to a larger product. Maybe I was cooking half chickens, or maybe I had two different sized chickens that I was cooking at the same time. I could remove the smaller ones and then simply select to advance the probe to the larger, and it would continue cooking. If I wanted to add, for whatever reason, just a couple of minutes on the chicken, I could hit the continue with time button. Or one of my favorite features for those high production situations, if I had another batch of chicken going in, say another two racks that had to follow this one, I could just simply then hit the new batch button, load the chicken, insert the core temperature probe, close the door, and the iCombi Pro will continue to cook. Now with the new iCombi Pro, we actually have the ability to run an ultra-fast interim clean. And I can simply do that by going to select the iCare system, and I'm gonna go right here to the fast cleaning. Right now the iCombi Pro is telling me that the cooking cabinet is too hot, so I'm simply gonna remove any pans and grids from the interior cabinet. It wants me to close the door. And now it's telling me to open the door so it will engage the fan to cool down your iCombi Pro. We'll let that cool down and we'll come right back to the ultra fast clean. Well, the unit's fully cooled down now, and it's actually telling me that it wants me to add two of our active green tablets, and also it's giving me the indication to remove any grids and containers. And now I'm going to close the door. Nice thing about when you're doing that chicken production and the new ultra-fast clean is you have the ability to clean after every other batch or clean in between batches, which is great for the life cycle of your equipment, and it keeps nice, clean, hygienic for the next staff or the next group or the next shift that might be coming in to continue cooking chicken throughout the day. So let's have a look inside of those chickens. So there you have, nice and crispy on the outside, lovely and juicy on the inside. For any more tips and tricks that you might be curious in, please feel free to contact us on the Rational Chef line at any time.